So occasionally, samples that are collected, especially those that are collected at the beach, can contain quite a bit of sand. And if that sand is filtered with your sample, it can make it difficult to see the plastic in between the sand grains. So we have a tool here called a separatory funnel that we can use to remove the sand from the sample and then filter the remaining water. So if your sample, when you look at it from below, contains quite a bit of sand, that's when you'll want to use the separatory funnel. As with everything else in this project, we're going to need to triple rinse our separatory funnel with our filtered water. The easiest way to do that is actually to open the valve at the bottom of the separatory funnel. So when the handle is up and down, that means the valve is open and water will drain right through it. And we're simply going to spray water through and make sure that we completely coat it at least three times. Okay, we'll close the valve, put the stopper on, place our separatory funnel back in our ring stand. We're now ready to add our sample. I'm just going to go ahead and shake it up, get all of that sand suspended, and carefully pour the sample into the separatory funnel. We're now going to wait a minute or so. As you can see, the sand is starting to settle in the bottom of that funnel. And you may need to leave it sit for 5, 10, 20, 30 minutes until the sand settles. If you have a lot of fine silt in there, it can take several hours. You might even want to leave it overnight to let it settle. But the heavy sand grains tend to settle relatively quickly. Once your sand is settled, you see that layer there at the bottom of the flask, we're simply going to open the valve, drain that sand off, and go ahead and close the valve. And we'll wait another minute or so to see, allow some additional sand grains to fall, and drain those off. We're not too worried about losing plastics in the sample because the plastics should be floating up close to the surface at this point. We should just be removing sand in this manner. We're now ready to go ahead and take our sample and filter it, and we'll simply pour it straight from the separatory funnel instead of pouring it from the sample collection bottle. And otherwise, the filtration process is exactly the same as with any other sample.